Today we would like to announce the Illinois State Police Region 1 and local law enforcement agencies motorcycle aggressive driving suppression initiative. This initiative, with data derived from our intelligence-led policing model, is designed to stop aggressive motorcycle driving on Chicagoland expressways and communities adjacent to the expressways. The sole purpose of this initiative is to reduce the number of serious crashes and fatalities involving motorcycles.
In 2006, there were 132 motorcycle fatalities statewide. 49 of those fatalities occurred in Region 1 on our Chicagoland expressways. In 2007, motorcycle fatalities increased to 157 statewide. 61 of those occurred on our Chicago area expressways. And for the first 6 months of 2008, there have been 56 motorcycle fatalities across the state. 18 of those occurred on our expressways here in Chicago. I've asked another partner to join us and talk about motorcycle safety operations. The Illinois State Police recently had the opportunity to work directly with this individual on an annual sponsored charity motorcycle ride. The Q101 rocket ride spanned 4 state police districts and drew over 1,200 motorcycle enthusiasts, ultimately arriving safely at its destination in Skokie. In addition, he's the co-host of the Sherman and Tingle Show on Q101 here in Chicago. Sherman?
And as the lieutenant was saying, we do an annual rocket ride, and I cannot tell you how proud I was of everybody that made the ride. There were no accidents, there was no arrests, everybody followed and obeyed the laws. I can't tell you how much I stressed that we need to follow the laws, that we can't screw around with so many people all riding in such close vicinity. I mean, if one little thing goes wrong, everybody goes down like dominoes. And everybody was great, and if everybody on the roads could do that, then we really wouldn't have any problems. And, you know, it's a weird thing. Sport bikes, it's kind of a younger demographic. There's a younger person that usually is riding a sport bike, and at that same respect, it's usually the bike that everybody starts out on. So a lot of times you have a beginner rider on a sport bike and they don't really understand the power that is entailed in one of these machines. I mean, there's not many vehicles an 18-year-old can go buy for $15,000-$16,000 that reach speeds of 200 miles per hour. So this is one of those. And if we could get everybody just to respect the speed of that and the power of that, because a lot of people that speed on the highway, they don't understand how much time it's going to take to decelerate. If you're going 120 miles per hour and decelerating to 60 from a car that's right behind you, sometimes an 18-year-old or a 25-year-old just starting out a bike might not know that. And there's a time and a place for 120 miles per hour and wheelies and things like that. I can tell you for myself, the Illinois State Police say it's not on the Illinois State highways. There is a time and a place for that. And you just need to find that place, whether it be an isolated area, kind of like the rocket ride where we had some people come out and do wheelies and race around. And I know that a lot of sport bike riders look at the police as the enemy, like, oh, they're out to get us. That's not the case. They just want everybody to be safe. They want to protect us and protect everybody else in case something does go wrong. So if everybody follows the law, obey the law, and just respects the machine they're on, we'll have plenty of years to enjoy motorcycling in the state of Illinois. Thank you.